Our Providence contact has shared the identity of the Shadow Client, a former mercenary and bodyguard by the name of Lucas Gray. His past is a black void, but our analysts are digging deep. Meanwhile, we've had a breakthrough of our own. Comparing the malicious attack patterns with global shipping and transportation routes, we've figured out how Mr. Gray and his paramilitaries move around the world undetected. They're using the distribution network of the Delgado Cartel, Colombia's biggest drug manufacturer. Clearly, Gray must have struck a deal with the Delgados. Consequently, if we can cripple the cartel, we can severely limit the militia strike range. But to do so, we need to slay a three-headed serpent. Sociopathic cartel head Rico Delgado and his two closest lieutenants, PR guru Andrea Martinez and savant chemist Jorge Franco. With equal parts guts and guile, Rico Delgado runs a thriving billion-dollar criminal empire. The word is, the brutal and volatile cartel head is hell-bent on becoming the number one drug lord in the world. To achieve this, Martinez, a childhood friend of Delgado's, has been buttering up state leaders and decision-makers, paving the way for an expansion of the Delgado logistics network, while the brilliant but aloof and antisocial Franco has been hard at work developing a new type of super cocaine. So, three of Colombia's most infamous crime lords inhabiting a decidedly hostile environment. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Colombia, 47. The remote village of Santa Fortuna awaits you deep inside the Colombian rainforest. An iron-fisted Delgado cartel rules over the village and its surroundings. Security around Santa Fortuna and the closed-off cartel compound is extremely tight. Armed sicarios patrol the streets of the village, ready to enforce harsh punishments to those who do not comply. Rumors persist of hidden transportation cave systems connecting the village, the cartel compound, and the hidden coca fields beyond. It is a rare occurrence to have all three cartel leaders present in the village at the same time. Expect that all targets are protected by scrupulous killers armed with automatic weapons. Rico Delgado inhabits his fortified mansion on the outskirts of the village, while Andrea Martinez can be found in her village office or around Santa Fortuna itself. And Jorge Franco is engaged in development of a new drug in his field laboratory. Happy hunting, 47.
Tell me what's happening in your life.
The biggest celebrity tattoo artist in the world.
Maybe he's here to see that Delgado guy we've been hearing about. Sounds like he's got money to spare.
Could be.
So, P-Power, celebrity tattooist of Tattoo Torment fame, has come to Santa Fortuna, presumably to work his magic on Rico Delgado, a known ink enthusiast. Sounds like an invitation to the mansion, 47. Are you feeling expressive?
Guys,
Wish I could afford one of his pieces.
Ah, his work isn't that impressive. All he really needs to do is cut up and cover up the spot.
Coming down to us dirty villagers to unveil some ridiculous statue.
Sure. I was at the bar last night and the band were really good. Both wicked music and music. But my husband told me nobody could do that.
That is P. Power, real name Paul Powers, celebrity tattoo artist and reality TV star.
No.
Hey, que pasa?
Lady, I'm trying to make a phone call. Just here. Buzz off, will ya?
Ay, andate la mierda.
You have to get me the hell out of here. I'm stuck in some tequila bar in the middle of nowhere. Okay. I can't get out. Dexy, send help.
Why? All right.
Mate, I'm telling you.
I've been in some crazy.
Just knock on the front gate, and then what? Walk in and tattoo the world's most notorious cartel boss.
I can see how that's not easy.
Oh, come on, fuck it. Imagine what he'd do to me if I messed up.
Oh, sure, he's dangerous. But this is wife you need to look out for, caballero. I'm a dead man.
Yeah, Dexy, it's me. Look, I'm in real trouble. I'll be back, all right?
Hey, you. Go to the green bin. We try to recycle around here. I'm serious.
So exactly how dangerous is this Delgado carrying?
How steady are your hands?
I don't follow. Sir, please refrain from throwing stuff around.
I don't follow.
Bueno, let me put it this way.
If he or his wife isn't happy with your work...
Uh-huh. See what that was? Let's go!
Yeah, all right.
Probably check that out.
No problem. get you.
Does that foundation look entirely stable to you?
Well, I think that's amazing, but no. How is that?
That power guy? Hang on, man. I hope you don't mind, but we need to frisk you.
Down if you want to come through here, Marcelo.
You're entering the lion's den, 47. Tread carefully. Practically everyone here is dangerous, not least Rico Delgado himself.
We're good. Keep moving. Keep moving.
No, it's this way. Come here. All right, Mr. Power. Follow me to the house. This is Delgado wanted to meet you. Thank you, Rico. My sister got a tattoo once. It was supposed to be a tribute to her son, but the guy fucked it up. Baby Gustavo ended up looking like a dead chupacabra. When my brother-in-law saw the tattoo, he went down to the guy's house. Shot him dead. Which was kind of dumb, because he was the only tattoo artist around for 100 miles.
That's quite a story.
You bet.
That is Catalina Delgado, wife to Rico Delgado for the past 11 years.
Really, you? B-Power, it's such an honor to meet you. I just love your show. That episode where you tattoo the heart on the arm of the dead dying policeman while they're administrating CPR? It's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen.
A great moment. I cherish the memory to this day.
Oh, see. So, Rico has this tattoo on his neck, and he insists it's supposed to be based on a photo of me. I'm not a fool, Mr. Powers. My nose never looked like that, not even before the operation. And sure, I've had a few ticks done here and there, but nothing as drastic as that. I want you to make it look like me, not some young skank.
I'll do my very best, Mrs. Delgado.
Ah, oh, Chico. Let me just grab a quick selfie with you, all right?
Sure, why not?
Yay! Just look this way. Okay, see, wow. We look so good together. This is great.
Thank you.
So far, so good, 47. Now to leave your mark on Mr. Delgado.
How much for a cover-up?
This is the famous peep out. Tattoo artist to the stars. You don't exactly look like you do on TV, do you?
There's something different about you.
Cariño, don't insult our guest. He's obviously not been sitting in a stylist chair for days, but this is P-Power. Who else would it be?
Well, what about those cheekbones? The guy on TV didn't have cheekbones like that.
Hey, Rico, enough. You know they fix all that in post-production. Just let the man work.
Okay, fine. Whatever you say. Okay, I'm ready. Let's get this thing fixed.
Stop doing that!
It's not every day we have celebrities visiting, you know?
You can't focus here, all right?
I really can't see what the problem is.
So what are we waiting for, huh? I'm here, I'm ready. Get on with it.
Are you doing this just to annoy me, Kat?
Oh, stop being so grumpy, Rico.
I find your constant photography very annoying, dear.
You're being such an ass.
Whoa, hey, Rico, don't worry. I've got this under control. Hey, tattoo guy. I'm watching you. One wrong move, you know, SRPEN. You hear me?
Hey, listen, you're taking this new bodyguard job a little too seriously, Jose.
Just doing what's necessary, Rico.
You're taking it too far, Jose. No guns.
I'm sorry, but I'm just doing my job, patron.
I'm not paying you to just hang around, amigo. Get that needle to work, or you'll be sorry. Calm down, all right? Everything's okay here.
Just making sure the script doesn't try anything funny.
Hey, I need you to stand down. Stop waving that thing around.
No.
You need to keep still, Mr. Delgado. I wouldn't want to stab you by accident.
You heard the man, Catalina. Leave us now.
Fine. Have it your way. But that tattoo better look exactly like me when you're done with your new BFF, Rico.
Hey, relax, Jose. We're fine.
He's a stranger, Rico. I don't like his face.
You're making me nervous, Jose. Put that thing away.
Afraid I can't do that, patron. This parse might get the jump on us.
Hey, Jose, I need you to leave us alone now. You're too wound up right now. You understand?
All right, boss, all right. But I'll be back in a little while if I don't hear from you, huevón.
Oh, finally. Some peace and quiet.
Can I finish my work now?
Do what you do best, man.
You got it.
Rico Delgado has been eliminated. Nicely done.
waiting room.
Staying or leaving?
For my family. I'll help my brother with you.
I get it.
Pero es que yo no estoy disponible para quedarme aquí todo. Acabamos con un momento.
How they had 15 guys in lockup in Mala, yet all of them worked 2 hours after Brim broke in?
Well, that's only half the story.
That is Andrea Martinez, the Delgado cartel PR officer and public face.
I don't want anything to do with that moronic Hector, no matter how many flowers or boxes of chocolates he sends me.
At ease.
Say hi.
Lots of things to take care of still, Miss Martinez. There's few calls you need to make to our connection in the Mexican government. And we have received a few invitations to various affairs you will need to look at as well. Mostly things connected with raising funds for elections.
All right. Relay it all to the Bogota office. I'll look at it when I've left this place.
I can't wait for this thing to be done. I'm tired of lazy workers and holy men having to perform God knows what rituals.
Everything will solve itself eventually, Miss Martinez.
Paula, let's go make that call in the downstairs meeting room.
As you wish, Miss Martinez.
Perdona, señor. I think I found the weapons.
Don't worry about it. I'm a professional, okay?
No problem.
Fine.
Thank you.
Martinez is down. Good work.
Gosh darn it.
Hey, what's up, man? Sit down. Relax. The universe will correct itself, right?
I know, man. I've been, like, smuggling this cocaine souvenir around the world, right? I need to get it to this dude, Franco. Man, it broke. It's supposed to be in one piece when I deliver it over by some cave entrance behind the pharmacy. But it broke.
Bummer, man. Maybe just...
So, a drug dealer from Sapienza has been testing a new method for smuggling Delgado brand cocaine into Europe, baking the substance into souvenirs, coated in a special anti-drug detection paint solution. The dealer has been traveling the globe, testing the method. However, he accidentally broke the souvenir on arrival and needs to mend it before going to see Franco.
Together?
I don't know. I think it's gonna ruin the taste test.
This Franco guy is like a bloodhound, but, you know, with taste, not smell. You know?
Yeah, man, that's...
I'm starting to get the impression that you don't get trusted.
Hello, Private. And how may I help you today, senor?
I'd like to buy some glue, please.
No, I'm afraid we just ran out of that item, senor. I sold the last bottle to the mechanic next door.
Hola. ¿Qué tal?
Do you sell glue?
A la puta!
Come on, look at it! It's a funny-looking vehicle, right? The tourists will be like, if I get in the back of this funny-looking thing,
I truly have a lot of fun myself. I even install a horn that goes, nyang, nyang.
Oye, I don't know what's going to get run into the ground first. This gas station or you and your stupid schemes?
Esta mierda keeps happening to me.
So, I'm gonna be needing some glue here. You happen to have any, my man?
No, as I've told you, you need to go to the show for that sort of thing.
Thanks for nothing, man. I can't go outside in my condition.
It's almost gone now. That was some good pot, man. I don't think I've seen colors like that ever before.
Pretty sure you turned into like a mantis shrimp at one point, man. You start like speaking in tongues or something.
Yeah, right off the hook.
Would you mind going to see what it is?
Okay, I got it.
Do me a favor and go check that out, okay?
We're over here.
You don't have to know somebody. It doesn't matter.
If you wanna come through, I'm gonna need to pat you down. You sure you don't got something on you? Nothing gets past me, you better tell me. Okay, everything seems to be in order here. Hey, you'll get to stepping, Holmes.
All right.
Mr. Franco is expecting you. Gabe's below. I'll just radio the hang on.
Interesting to see how many of you, backpacking types, are willing to bend your morals for a little cash.
I live by my own rules.
Isn't this kind of work sort of breaking the human code?
I do what it takes to get what I need.
Bring it home, Daddy.
Ah, you're expected. Have a seat. Franco's on his way.
Ah, so, despite an annoying delay, it's finally here. Let's have a look. It got through customs without a problem, we hope?
I had no issues.
Excellent. We're not sure whether this will pass the taste test, but that remains to be seen. Follow us, please.
Sup, yo?
Nice 147. And now for Franco to sample his handiwork.
Oh, make way!
All targets neutralized. This should paralyze the cartel. Excellent work, 47. Now head for...
Do you know Franco sampled his own goods?
Si, claro. He's got this crazy sense of taste. He's more accurate.
Ah, so, despite an annoying delay, it's finally here. Let's have a look. It got through customs without a problem, we hope?
I had no issues.
Excellent. We're not sure whether this will pass the taste test, but that remains to be seen. Follow us, please.
¿Cómo estás?
Nice one, 47. And now for Franco to sample his handiwork. All targets neutralized. This should paralyze the cartel. Excellent work, 47. Now head for an exit.
Thank you.
status. Columbia assignment successful. Tactical targets neutralized. Militia transport network disabled. Location of primary target unknown. Team chasing several leads. End message, encrypt and send.
Source checks out. We can prove the board knew about the chemical leaks. We'll have grounds for a retrial.
It won't make a difference. They're too powerful.
They're not the devil, Nancy. Just a company. They're not above the law, don't you see? This is bigger than James. Those bastards killed 80 people.
And they got away with it. Think about what that means.
No one's untouchable.
No one's untouchable.
Diana!
Coming!
We got what we came for. Move out.